Back when California voters passed Proposition 215, scientists didn't know much about marijuana's medicinal properties. Some state legislators wanted to change that, so they approached UC San Diego's Igor Grant.
My recommendation was, look, establish a center or a program, really, to study this, and it'll cost you some money, but these studies have not been done, basically.
Soon, Grant found himself in charge of the new state-funded Center for Medicinal Cannabis Research. It was an enviable position. Lots of scientists would love to do experiments using pot, but it's been incredibly difficult to study. The Drug Enforcement Administration lists marijuana as a Schedule I drug alongside heroin, LSD, and ecstasy. It's a category reserved for drugs with no medical value. Grant says his work would not have been possible if he'd proposed it directly to federal agencies.
Without the state of California saying, yes, we support this kind of work, we probably would never have gotten federal approval.
With California fully behind him, Grant worked with scientists throughout the UC system to complete a series of small human trials. A federally sanctioned marijuana farm at the University of Mississippi provided their samples.
It's just, it would be a joint, basically. Yeah, okay. But very professionally rolled, I might say. It looked like a cigarette. My understanding is they had an old cigarette rolling machine.
The joints all looked and smelled the same, but not all of them got subjects high. These studies required placebos, so some joints contained no THC, sort of like the pot version of decaf coffee. Grant managed to convince DEA agents that these samples would not leave the lab.
The DEA has to come locally and say, well, where are you going to store it? Let's look at your research pharmacy. In one case, they said, well, is that safe bolted to the floor?
Subjects smoked their joints in hermetically sealed rooms with no ventilation leading outside. Grant and his colleagues had to jump through lots of regulatory hoops to pull off the experiments. But Grant says once they were done, the findings were surprising.
I kind of expected, well, we're going to have a few studies that'll say yes and a few that'll say no, and then possibly at the end of the day we'll still be arguing. But in fact, every single study showed benefit.
Grant says it's now well established that marijuana can soothe neuropathic pain in patients with diseases like HIV/AIDS. It can reduce spasticity in multiple sclerosis, and perhaps obviously, it can stimulate appetite in underweight patients. Grant says there's now more than enough evidence to justify taking marijuana out of Schedule I. Other scientists agree. The American Academy of Pediatrics also recently called for rescheduling. Even the U.S. Surgeon General has said that marijuana can be helpful in some conditions. Alex Kreit, a professor at the Thomas Jefferson School of Law, says learning more about pot will be difficult without rescheduling.
It makes it very hard for researchers to get access to it. There are a whole host of hurdles that Schedule I drugs come with as far as research that Schedule II, III, and so forth just simply don't have.
A DEA spokesperson said the agency can't reschedule a marijuana without action from Congress or the FDA. As for any negative effects, Grant says the jury's out on how marijuana can affect teenage brains still under development, but he sees no clear evidence of long-term damage in adults.
It's completely incongruous that it's sitting in Schedule I with, other useless, dangerous drugs.
Grant says marijuana belongs in Schedule III, alongside small doses of codeine and some appetite suppressants, but he'd settle for Schedule II. David Wagner, KPBS News.